Just need a mod icon. Trolls don't get mod. Zombie. And you can't change the color on mobile.
But that meant there must be a destiny where he survived and won, right? Otherwise, what was the point? And with that, the book's pages fluttered back once more to the beginning, and the clouds parted over the Isles of Boreas. It was time to choose. The rebellion was in trouble. Ravens were scouting for the secret rebel base. They needed a game changer. Pieces of the Sky Ripper had surfaced.
Oh.
Or so a scholar in the mountains had told him. Surely the weapon that banished the lost gods could defeat the Emperor. Also, a temple had risen out of empty desert. The Emperor had brought the Sky Ripper pieces up out of ancient burial by his obscene rituals. Could this be where the Iblis Stone was hidden? Someone better get it before he does, thought Renardo. On the other hand, his old friend Lupino needed rescuing. Lupino was no game changer, but could Renardo really leave an old friend to the Ravens?
Okay, something's changed. And I'm not quite sure because... of the lock. Those weren't there before. So does that mean that something changes when we unlock all four truths? Anyway, guys. We need a game changer. Yeah, I don't know what the locks are. I don't know. So we need a game changer. Do we save Lupino? Do we go for the Sky Ripper? Or do we... go into the temple? Which should we do? That temple will be looking fine. Alright, we'll do the temple this time.
The island was windswept desert. No one went there except ostriches and ostrich hunters. The Iblis Stone. It sounded ominous. It sounded powerful. If the Emperor was searching for it, it must be dangerous. And so, Renardo went ostrich hunting.
Yeah, I don't know what the locks are there for. I think it has something to do with the four truths, which we only have one right now.
Every child could sing verses about the Sky Ripper, but ancient codices held hints of other things. A stone that ate souls, a ruby that drank blood, a jewel only a righteous man could give away. Were all these things the Iblis Stone? Long hidden in a buried temple, another ancient item that was only resurfacing now, drawn up from the deeps by the Emperor's horrific rituals.
Why only the one truth? Because that's all we unlocked right now. All the stories that we've done so far only led up to the one truth so far.
In this chest, there were woodcuts of amazingly beautiful vixens wearing no clothes at all. And something
that's
more
useful. More useful, dude. More useful than sexy fox anthro ladies. The rest are lies. The one truth that we know right now, and the one truth that we got, is that Zenobia still has feelings for Renardo. And that is the constant. We do have some pretty awesome swords, though. We have a maximum hero sword, a maximum firestorm sword, a wither sword, Wintereth. It's the only one that matters. All the swords seem pretty good.
Renato distrusted doors that opened automatically, especially after being buried for millennia. Was this some sort of trap? Burned fur. His.
My bad.
The ravens were already here, cawing in frustration. They were still searching for a way in. Good. Then he hadn't come too late.
I am kind of hurting after that, though. We do have a skill point.
He was more and more extraordinary.
And dead. Let's try that one again. Okay.
Once again. Renato was dead right.
Or actually extraordinarily dead. Yeah. Dang it!
I should have done a barrel roll.
I should have done a barrel roll, dude. I knew we were playing Star Fox. No, run, Renato! He won't run! Never mind.
I should go, he thought.
Man, why am I so bad at this? Star Fox 1 confirmed. Stupid thing keeps giving buffs to everybody. Okay, I guess I was just gonna stand there.
For some reason, Renata remembered a fairy tale his mother had told him. About a land where only the apes talked, and animals went around without clothes.
Several annoying frogs. Several? Is it more than one? Okay, that might help my situation. Or not.
What's for dinner, you thought? Hope it's not.
What is going
broccoli.
On here? Alright, let's go. I can't move! Man, that's so dumb. Like, if I get hit once, fine, but like, don't stun me to the point where I can't move and then take more damage. That's lame. Oh my gosh, it's over.
Renato had learned so much. It was time to turn it into something he could use.
That was terrible. And not any health to be found whatsoever.
It was time for a little exploration.
Find the stone! You have been chosen in this critical mission for your ability to follow orders to the letter. Follow orders to the letter without question. Do you not believe the. Do not believe the naysayers. Your score in the intelligence test is only proof that you are better geared than anyone else to follow orders. Take pride in knowing that I, your emperor, have handpicked you for this mission. Follow the instructions to the letter. Always travel in pairs. Do not look at the engravings in the wall. Do not lose the hermetic box. When you find the stone, immediately place it in the box and seal the box. If you hear a voice in your head, ignore it. Remember, the temple is haunted, obviously. This is an old temple dedicated to an old evil god. There were blood sacrifices, of course, it would be haunted. Ignore the voice in your head. Remember, ghosts cannot hurt you, but they will try to confuse you. When you hear a voice, take the drowsy pill. if you meet another soldier with the stone and it's not the hermetic box, in the hermetic box, immediately spray them with drowsy gas. Find the stone, put it in the box, seal the box. And most important of all, find the stone. So the stone is very, very important, apparently.
There had to be something useful in these things, didn't there?
Yeah, that's a lot of war. I'll take it. Stone seems very dangerous. That too. Okay. I don't feel like that should have happened. And dead.
I can't be dying, he thought. I'm the hero.
Tarzan! Nice, and we got a gem. Attack speed. Yes, I will definitely use that. I don't ever use that, so we're gonna use the attack speed.
Renata felt restless. Maybe he could focus all that energy into something useful.
Looks like I'm still having issues with health, so I'm gonna go for a little bit more health. Beautiful. Let's go right in the fire. Man, these are really, really fast. Okay, I guess my dashing, like, means nothing.
The ravens at least could not get past this point. Obviously, the temple builders knew how to deal with
Tomb Raiders!
Renato had always wanted a flying carpet. This was more like a flying tabletop, but it would do. It was a stone of the purest blackness. It reflected no light, like a void made solid. Nervous, he picked it up. Who said that? It was the stone. Eager. Thirsty.
Kill the Emperor's daughter. Now you, Emperor.
That seemed tempting and terribly wrong. Zenobia was the Emperor's greatest general and a potent witch. But they had been close once. And Renardo wasn't sure he really wanted to be Emperor. Why not capture the core of Sky Ripper instead? It was the eye of a lost god torn out by the transcendent Emperor to power his greatest weapon.
Not the core,
said the stone anxiously.
Give me death. I will give you the power to take what you want.
I'm a thirsty stone. Okay, so we got another impasse. So, we got blood and death for Iblis, the Iblis stone. It promised great power in exchange for the blood of Zenobia, who was once close to Renardo. But she was also the Emperor's only daughter and greatest general. If it meant gaining enough power to turn the tide of the war and even defeat the Emperor, it might be worth the sacrifice. Or we can go, even without the armature, the core had power. But could Renardo really kill Zenobia, even if she was the Emperor's greatest general? Maybe Renardo could instead get the Sky Ripper's core. The Iblis Stone did not seem to like the idea at all. Was it afraid of the power of the core? We already did the core tonight. So which choice do you guys want? So not the core? Go with Zenobia? Which one, guys? As I take a quick snack. Go with the core. Zombie is right, we did do core once already. But we can do core again, because the whole story is different anyway. Alright, let's go with the core.
The stone bothered him. He hated being told what to do. Wasn't that why he joined the rebellion? Wasn't that why he'd refused to be a soldier? He'd agreed to come on board only if he could freelance. The stone felt a bit clingy. The sage Calaveras had told him where to find the Sky Ripper, a weapon capable of challenging the gods. Even without its armature, the core would still possess great power. He would go there.
I feel like these stories are real, real snug. I'm really enjoying this game a lot.
The moment he landed the Farfarer, Renardo had a rare feeling of regret. It's not too late.
he thought. You could turn around and sell for Zenobia's island. He frowned. Wait a minute. He didn't want to kill Zenobia, did he? Sure, technically she was the enemy, but they'd been at sword food school together. They'd never been lovers, but somehow they'd been closer. She'd told him every secret about herself. Except the biggest one. That she was the Emperor's daughter.
No. Kill Zenobia.
Whispered the stone.
Before it's too late.
Dear Zenobia, the director of the Academy has told me how much he was impressed by your academic performance and leadership. Somehow, I doubt this season, this was a season of boot licking. I've seen plenty of those. That old toad is sincere. I'm proud of you, my daughter. You will make a fine empress one day. On my end, great news. Professor Cavalieris has been studying the Nexus, and he has made a bold observation. That toad is a true genius. You know how the island is unique, constantly changing. New crystalline formations appearing, island fragments merging, splitting, slowly drifting, held together by some invisible threads. Professor Cavalieris is convinced those changes are not random, but rather indicative, maybe? Of the living nature of the islands. He has observed that certain changes on the Nexus follow, or sometimes precede, a turbulence on another island. Landslides, quakes, floods. The Nexus seems to resonate with those events. Maybe the islands are of a hive mind, and the Nexus is the brain. In any case, I am funding a permanent scientific observatory on the Nexus. It will attract the Empire's greatest minds with Professor Cavalieris at the helm. I anticipate the great age of enlightenment for the Empire. With love, Father. And we only have 8 HP, so we're gonna die again. Yep.
Alas, they had to bury him in a bucket. Actually, several buckets.
Saw that coming. Oh, I didn't want to start all the way at the beginning again. Dang. I guess it's not really that far.
Beautifully. Where was a bard when you needed one?
Nice, big chest. Shield breaker level 2. Nice. See what happens when battles just aren't douchebaggy and they're actually good?
There was something sour in the air. Like the earth had ruptured over something that had been fermenting for a very long time. He wished there were more pylons he could use the hook on. He really needed to construct additional pylons.
Not douchebaggy, definitely not Dark Souls.
The stone hadn't lied about what it could do for him. With each raven he cut down, he felt a jolt of power flowing into his arm.
You're weak,
whispered the stone.
The call will kill you.
Are you afraid of it?
No, don't be ridiculous.
It chuckled.
But it's unstable. It'll poison you if someone just carried it, and if you try to use it, it will explode catastrophically.
Renardo did not trust rocks that talked in his head. He went onwards.
Yeah, you gotta watch those rocks that talk in your head, dude. Those are the worst.
Sorry, mustache, thought Renardo. This couldn't be good for global warming.
So I did notice, for all the hero wall doors, the hero sword doors, you don't need to switch your sword for.
Smell any better dead, Renardo thought. As he approached the core, the stone became hysterical. He had a sudden vision of plunging his gauntlet into the core and dying in anguish. That wasn't his vision, was it? The stone had sent him its darkest fears, hadn't it? He had a sudden impulse to do exactly that. He raised his right fist and plunged it into the core. There was a rush of light. He thought he could hear the stone screaming. And then he passed out. When Renardo came to, the core was gone. But the Ibla stone was no longer black, but glowing with a blue light. And it was silent. I can't hear you, he sang out, and yoo-hoo! It didn't answer. Ha, he said. He had defeated the demonic gem with the power of his mind. He felt invincible. It was time to attack the Imperial outpost on the Nexus. Take the battle to the enemy. But among the huge crystals, there was also an observatory. A wise man would probably ask the scientists exactly what he had first. How wise was he?
Okay. So, another choice. Never hurts to ask for advice. You can always ignore it. Renardo was able to silence the Iblis stone using the Sky Ripper's core. Yet, the power it gave him was intact. It would be wise to understand what he had done. The scientists at the Nexus would have the answers. Or we could just go right into battle. What was it about not looking a gift horse in the mouth? Maybe it was time to use this power in to turn the tides. Destroying the enemy outpost on the Nexus would be the great first step. So what do you guys think? Which one should we go with? For those of you out there watching. You think we should ask the scientists? Asking the scientists is a good idea. That's the one I was kind of thinking about too, to be honest. We'll go with the scientists.
As the Farfarer made its way toward the Nexus, Renata could see tiny sparks in the blackness that was the Iblis Stone, as if somewhere within it, the core was still spitting out energy, which the Iblis Stone sucked in hungrily. You'd think the stone would want this kind of power, wouldn't it? Thought Renardo. Well, the scientists would explain it all.
Thank you for the host, Evic. Appreciate it. How did the tournament go, my friend?
See? He'd trusted his gut, and it had worked out. That's what it meant to be a hero, to ignore the naysayers and the odd makers, and do what you knew was right, and have it turn out to be the right thing. Well, he wasn't worried. Once he got to the observatory, the scientist toads could explain it. Then he could carry the war into the enemy's camp and destroy them all. Oh dear, he was getting a little bloodthirsty, wasn't he? That was always a rush.
So for those of you joining, just joining, we are getting snug to some stories, Paths of Destiny. And in the story so far, in tonight's story.
Once, he found a Superman issue number 1 in mint condition in a jar he'd broken. He planned to keep breaking things until he had the whole series.
Still funny. But in the story so far, we went to a desert temple. We found an evil stone that was possessed with the powers of darkness. Then we went and basically purified it. And now we're going to some scientists of the enemy's scientists, to figure out what we'd done specifically.
Come in handy in a pinch.
Please.
Renato had never felt better in his life. Normally, a battle would wear him down and he would need a night's sleep. Now he felt like he could go all night and all day. He felt like people were cheering him on, and he could practically hear their applause as he slew one raven after another. Imagine getting a horse up in one of these things. He would be cursing a blue streak. The Imperial fleet was closing in on the rebels, forcing them to come out and fight. Bernardo was itching to bring the fight to the enemy. He had to remind himself not to be too reckless. I need more materials, thought Bernardo.
So what am I missing? I need two more wind essences, and then we can get a void sword. There's two more.
Energy spheres. Easy to dodge, but why do they sting if you didn't pay attention?
Dang. Got owned. Let's try that again.
You had a fly.
There was a cat in this one.
A cat.
And something useful.
And something useful.
The toads at the observatory measured the stone with their occult devices. I fed it the core of Skyripper, explained Renato. No more Vivi Palanzols.
But the core is not an unlimited energy source, said one toad.
Another said,
there's a feedback loop, you see, which could overload the stone.
The stone doesn't actually feed on souls, claimed a third, but on pain of killing another sentient being. If you can truly be at peace with yourself, it would not overload.
This was all very confusing. At peace? Yes, the mountains were peaceful and quiet, but Hino had the power to turn the tides. He should report to the Rebellion Council and prepare for the decisive battle.
At peace. Yes, that almost makes sense. The core was protecting Renardo from the Iblis Stone's dark influence, but too much killing would overload it. He had to find inner peace to maintain balance. But overloading the core did not sound reassuring. Maybe Renardo could find peace real quick. Then go back into the fray in time and save the rebellion. To the mountains he would need to go. Or... the rebellion would depend on him. But finding peace takes time. And the rebellion was running out of time. Renardo had to focus on the mission. He had to save the rebellion while there was still a rebellion to save. To the rebel base. For peace. We're gonna go try to find inner tranquility. Alright, we'll go with the peace.
The one thing he understood from all the Toad arguments, maybe the stone did not feed on blood or souls or rage. It fed on empathy. It fed on the pain he felt when he put an end to another being's existence. Even if that other being was a raven intent on killing him, if he could find peace, then he could use the power of the Ibla Stone without being taken over by its evil. The mountains. He would go to the mountains. He could find peace there. Unfortunately, the mountains were not empty. There were ravens everywhere. No matter. He had to fight, yes, but he didn't have to be angry. Parry, dodge, slash, and breathe. Yes, focus on the rhythm, the dance of it. Not on the blood or the raven's caw as they died. Ah, it was working. He wasn't feeling those dark jolts of eldritch energy. He wasn't feeling the Iblis Stone.
Finished your homework? Nice. See? And now you get to enjoy some Snug stories. While you relax for the rest of the night.
Renata had been the terror of the sandcastles when he was two. These platforms were great. Renato wanted one for his house. The stone was still silent. His mind was his own, and his heart, too. He bore them no ill will, these ravens. They were doing their job. They were expressing their nature. Dance, whirl, parry, jab, and breathe. It was all so simple, wasn't it? But something was missing. He didn't feel truly at peace. Wait. Wasn't this near where Calaveras lived? The sage would help him figure it all out.
What treat did I get earlier?
Renato's paws were getting numb. Calaveras really didn't want company, did he?
I grabbed a Pop-Tart.
Toad looked down, he thought.
Hot Fudge Sunday.
The Iblis Stone, silenced by the Sky Ripper's core, had given Renato enough power to challenge the Imperial fleet. But what Renato was seeking was inner peace. The rebellion was on the verge of extinction, but it would have to wait.
I like the Hot Fudge Sunday Pop-Tarts as well. But no, these ones are just like cookies and cream, whatever. Pop-Tarts.